Well, it's funny. It actually goes back to my parents because they installed solar panels at their house where I grew up in Vermont. They have solar trackers that follow the sun, and I thought it was kind of crazy at the time. And eventually, they were talking to me. And they're like, "Have you heard of this company called Tesla?" So I started to build a relationship with Tesla. I ended up buying one of the cars and thinking, "Wow, this is really the next step is electric cars. You know, it's a lot more sustainable. The car is just really fast. I like that. It wasn't just like a save the whales environment." Thing. So I ended up buying a Tesla, building a relationship with them, getting solar panels installed on my house, which also powers the studio. I have a home studio. So doing this whole, you know, multi-angle sort of environmental approach to the studio and the music, everything's powered by the sun. The car is powered by the sun. It's all offset by solar power. And that inspired the name for the album, DC to Light. So, you know, I think you got to do everything you can just to eliminate waste. And it's so simple to me to just have, you know, have panels on your roof. Like, you might as well do that. And some of these solutions are really cool. Like, they're talking about solar powered roads. Solar roadways was a big Kickstarter campaign. I donated to that this year. That could be really interesting. But I think, yeah, there isn't really a discussion going on with the artists. And it's funny because now Deadmau5 has a Tesla, Zedd has a Tesla, Diplo has one. And they don't really portray themselves as like environmental crusaders or anything like that. But you know, they like fast cars and they like technology. It's a natural fit for EDM. But I think there needs to be more discussion about it. And it's something I'd like to do, kind of maybe have a creative advisory group or something for Tesla or for SolarCity and do more with the reach that we have at these festivals.